The South African wool industry is in a privileged position and has ample opportunity for growth. Wool prices in South Africa are stabilizing after the negative impact of COVID. The world is moving from local and national markets towards a global system of trading, which means that neighboring farmers working on small plots of land may be competing with large industrial farmers from another country in a single marketplace, resulting in increased pressure on farmers in developing countries to commercialize their operations. The Center for Sustainable Agriculture submitted a proposal building competitiveness for communal farmers through developing the wool value chain in the Free State Province of South Africa as part of a bid for a project to the Regional Universities Forum for Capacity Building in Agriculture, or RUF Forum. The proposal was selected and the grant was awarded to the center. With the support of the university estates, we could upgrade the shearing shed and establish a wool processing unit on the Paradise Experimental Farm. We also acquired 100 Dooney Merino ewes to be part of this and other projects. With the assistance of a wool processing expert and the appointment of 2 people to man the production of wool products, we are ready to kickstart the project. The project has many components. Firstly, this project is designed to incorporate research and dissemination components, where 5 students, whereof 2 PhD and 3 master students, are doing research on various aspects of the wool value chain. The research component will include the evaluation, testing and further development of certain technologies and social and economic situations.
RIF Forum and the university give us this platform to develop skills, and by developing all the processes of the wool value chain, we can ensure that the small-scale farmer can ensure a better classed wool clip at the end of the day. And of course, there's other products they can also make on ground level.
The project means a lot. Since I've joined the RUF Forum, it has actually transformed my life. I didn't have much experience about wool. I only knew the theory, but now I can apply, I can do field working, I can classify wool, I know how to shear wool, so I've learned a lot. It has equipped me and opened so many doors for me.
I think one of the things I value most about this project is that it's given me an opportunity to see my research in practice and to really build networks with people that are in the industry and farmers, and I'm really looking forward to applying that in my career going forward.
This project means for me that I get the opportunity to grow in terms of knowledge, because the research will also enhance my abilities. But the one thing that I like about it is the fact that it will help the farmers that we'll be working with to have more knowledge based on what we'll be researching about.
Yeah, this project provides an opportunity for me to learn. Since I've been part of this project, I've learned so much about wool and working with the people. So for me, it means this opportunity that I'm learning, and also I get to share my knowledge with others, same as they share theirs with me.
The second objective, which is the transformation of communal wool growers' production from an underachieving enterprise to a profitable, sustainable and renewable venture to enhance the livelihoods of communal wool producers, are made possible by intensive sheep management and wool classing training courses.
It means a lot because we learn a lot here about the vaccinating of the sheep and the processing of the wool. It's going to help me to bring a profit to my farm. It's going to help all of the farmers here. It's a lot of information that we get from this day.
Before, you used to put everything in one bag. But after this presentation here last time, I knew that I'll have to separate this, must be separated to that. That's why I'm here again, because there's information that I've missed based on classing, so that I can be well equipped for the future, knowing how to write my own bags and all those things.
Processing of wool and classing of a wool helped me a lot, because I'm also helping other people who cannot do what I'm doing.
Thirdly, capacity building of members from the community are an integral part of this project, where they are trained in the different aspects of wool processing, like wool washing, carding, spinning, colouring, weaving and knitting.
It means a lot to me because I'm really interested in
agriculture. I really love agriculture. And then my intention to come here was to learn about classification of the wool.
I'm coming to this training because I want information to how to use the wool. Inside I have information that wool is very important because you can make bags with wool, jersey, you can make blankets with wool. The wool is very important.
With these skills, we want to assist them to become entrepreneurs in their own right and assist their families financially. Since the project is multidisciplinary, together with the Center for Sustainable Agriculture, the Departments of Consumer Science, the Department of Animal, Wildlife and Grassland Science, and the Department of Agricultural Economics are part of this project. Other stakeholders like the Glen Agricultural College and private sector role players like BKB, OVK and the National Wool Growers Association are also involved in this project. We would like to thank Roo Forum and the University of the Free State for their continued support during this project, and we believe that this project would positively influence the livelihoods of communal and small wool farmers, as well as members from the community and the wool industry as a whole in the Free State and even further.